the importance of marketing has been manifold. To discuss different strategies, segmentation, and penetration apart from promotions, we must learn the various concepts as it has been given in your syllabus and also SLMs. Now I request Sri Srimaya Paricha to come to the point where he can start marketing. The irony is that now, in the present pandemic situation, discipline is also marketed sometimes. So I request for Sri Paricha to highlight the different aspects of today's topic, and the stage is set. You are most welcome, Sri Paricha. And I'll be also available with you to support at the point of need. And Dr. Jena is also there. Okay, Sri Paricha, you can take over, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Prithviraj sir. Am I audible?
Yes, very much, sir. Clear.
So very good afternoon to all the learners. I welcome you to this session of marketing. Before starting of this session, I would like to thank all of my colleagues, Dr. Anshuman Jena, who is the technical support to this session, Mr. Prithviraj Mishra, and Mr. Kirod Maharana. They might be playing the role of moderators. Even if Prithviraj sir has some preoccupations, but still he stayed on. So I would like to thank him for that. So it's a request to all the learners within this session, please keep your mic on mute mode and don't present anything. Otherwise, it would distract myself from presenting anything. So at the same time, I would request Dr. Jena to share the PPT and we'll start the session. So today's topic is understanding consumers and selecting target markets. So it is about the buying behavior. It has different names like how a consumer or how a customer behaves when he goes for make a purchase. Because you might come across some people or you can ask yourself, whenever you go to market, you have lots of different things in your mind. Sometimes you get tempted by seeing something is very, that is called something is an impulsive decision making, or you can say that time you get tempted and you make a sudden decisions. And sometimes you take a longer period of time to reach at the decision, whether to buy or not to buy. Sometimes you deviate from the predetermined purchase and at the last moment, you change and you go to another product for the purchase. So today's, those are the topics to be discussed. One, the buyer behavior, and second one is markets and market segmentation, and third one is market targeting and market positioning. So may I request Dr. Jena to go to next slide? Yes. So you can say buying behavior, buyer behavior, or it is otherwise known as consumer buying behavior. And it is much more like an answer to those kind of questions like why, when, what, how, where, when. That means what to purchase, why to purchase, where to purchase, how to purchase, and what to purchase. So there are a number of questions and they are to be answered through this studying consumer behavior. And It really started in the 1960s, but it doesn't have any kind of very organized research about the consumer behavior. So consumer behavior is absolutely interdisciplinary because it has been contributed by different field subjects. And those subjects are psychology is a study of individual, sociology is a study of groups, and the social psychology is a study of how an individual operates in groups. Anthropology, to study the influence of the society on the individual, and the economics. And so on, number of disciplines are there, they contributed towards the consumer behavior. And this slide, it really symbolizes what to do, what to buy, when to buy, where to buy, how often buy, and how to buy also, and how to use, where to use, when to use, and number of questions. And those questions will be answered through the studying consumer behavior. Next slide, please. So what is the importance of the buyer studying buyer behavior or consumer behavior? So the first one is making the marketing strategy. Because post-globalization, competition is very tough, and that company is successful, which is capable of understanding its customers to a better level, or very effectively they're understanding their needs. Consumer differentiation. If you are able to differentiate your consumers, like through the consumer behavior, because no company is able to serve or cater all the customers alike. So they have to know, and which customer will behave in which way, because consumer behavior is dependent, or it is influenced by many of the factors we will decide later on. Retention of the consumer. When you are capable to understand your customers very effectively, then you are capable to retain back, because nowadays when competition is getting tougher and tougher, you have to be very careful about retaining customer. Once you have lost your customer, that means gradually you are losing your sales. You might have seen that when Dhirubhai Ambani's Reliance is segregated, is divided into two groups, one to Mukesh Ambani and another to Anil Ambani. Mukesh Ambani grew like anything, and Anil Ambani almost he went bankrupt. Why it happened? Because it is about the business. It is about the understanding of business. Here it is not the intention to comment on the capability of Anil Ambani, but still, when a company loses its customers, then the company is gone. Because for the customers only, company survives and it goes for the longer period of time. Through understanding the buying behavior or consumer buying behavior, a company is able to understand the market trend. What kind of trend is going on? What people like or dislike? Again, through the consumer behavior, we can understand the competition. What type of competition is there, whether it is very stiff, or it is really, it can have very loose competition, where whatever can be offered, that can be. Because when we see the period prior to 1991, when there was no competition, that was no stiff competition, the quality was not that much good. With the time, many of the foreign players, many of the multinational companies, they've started coming to India, and competition goes tougher and tougher. And which one that understands the competition very well, they can survive. Similarly, if the consumer behavior that motivates, that encourages the company to go for the better research and development, they can innovate new products. Pricing policies. Because you have to know You can really notice that some people, they are not so much eager to spend lots of money. Some people, they spend lavishly on different things. So it depends. And in some of the geographical locations, you'll find some people, ame jota ki odia re kahile kichi loka shanti bahut hi mane ame to conscious kahibani, but they take money or monetary value so seriously, and some people, they are extravagant and they spend lots of money for their the pleasure and number of holidaying and number of things. So it depends. So what should be the pricing policy? It can be known through the study consumer behavior. Next slide, please. So what are the factors that really influence consumer behavior? And that is psychological, social, cultural, personal, and economic. So those are the factors. Even some other factors are there, but when we speak broadly about those factors, those are the things: psychological, social, cultural, personal, and economic. Next slide, please. Please watch this slide very minutely, where it is categorized very, very finely, where if we see that motivational factor. If I take an example, okay, you want to purchase a laptop for your use or your purpose, or that might be some different issues, that might be some different purposes, psychological factors. What really motivated you to purchase the laptop? What you perceive about the different laptops? And there are a number of companies, we have different our perceptions. Like many people, they have very positive perceptions towards the Dell or HP. They might not have that good perceptions towards Acer, or might be some of the companies, they are not so so much available in the market. So it is about, again, it is about the perception. Learning, we learn from our surroundings. We learn from our surroundings that which brand is good, which brand is not good, which brand should be taken, which brand is having excellent after sales service, which brand is really, it's a selling like a hotcake in the market. We have to learn from our surroundings, our total reference groups and number of people we are associated with. Again, it depends on the attitudes, whether you have the positive attitude or the negative attitude. It is according to your perception. If your perception is negative, then your attitude will be negative. Like for any of the product, any of the brand for which you have been harassed for after sales service, and later on what happens, you have that attitude, very negative kind of perception as well as negative attitude towards that particular brand. So that depends. Like beliefs, it is believed that you know, whatever the Chinese product, it is not lasting, or it is not durable. It is a belief. Many of the people, it might be a myth, but the people believe that, oh, it's a China product, it might not last very longer. That's the thing. Second, see that the social factors. When we make any purchase, our family members, they are one of the main influences, because we take money from the family, or even if we are the breadwinner, still we take the advice, we take the suggestions from the family. Reference group. Your reference groups means your acquaintances, your family members are different, but reference groups, you belong to different groups, and you take, or you might follow those people, and you take their advice as the better advice for making the purchase of a particular product. Similarly, you might have role models, you might go for the status, many people, they buy some of the products not for the necessity. They buy the products for their status, their role in the society. Okay. Similar thing, the cultural factors. Again, like many, our if anything that is our culture is not allowing or that it is not very suitable to our culture, like Valentine's Day, they are well received in some parts, some culture, well received, not well received by some of the culture. It depends how it really matters. So it depends. Any purchase, anything that depends on the culture, what kind of culture you are having. You might have seen some of the Indians, some of the Indians, some parts of the Indians, they feel that they love to travel total India because they are the main tourists. Even you see that in Odisha, in Puri, you'll find many of the Bengali people, because they love the fun of traveling. And it depends. Different cultures, different they are having different they are preference, taste and preferences are according to their culture, their social class, and personal factors. Again, when your age is very tender age, or you are just in the middle age, your decision will be something different. When you are too old, your decision will be more matured, and sometimes it is very cautious, less risk taking. When you are young, you take more risk. That is the factor of the age. Income. You know that how income really matters when you go for any decisions. Occupation. According to occupation, we make many of the consumer buying behavior decisions. According to that, because if you are executive, laptop, mobiles, and many of the gadgets, it will be very essential. It might be very essential for you. But when you are a laborer, you are working in a field, what is the need of a laptop? So that depends. What is your occupation? What is the need of that? And lifestyle. Many people that having or purchasing some of the things, they reflect their lifestyle. So they make the purchase for only that thing. I switch on to next point, economic. Okay, again, personal income or family income or income expectations or consumer credit or savings, because all those things then that matter when a buying behavior is saved. According to that, if your personal income is not that much, you will restrict yourself from buying the higher models or higher cost or luxury items. And that depends from which, or in sometimes what happened when you expect that your income will be it will be more, it will be increasing, it will increase in the future, that time you might go for some of the purchase because it is about the future expectation of your income. Next slide, please. Yes, so those are the types of buying behavior. In four quadrants, you'll find four things: that complex buying behavior, dissonance reducing buying behavior, variety seeking buying behavior, and habitual buying behavior. Where when it is seen that when involvement is high and there are differences in the brands is significant. When we go for making the purchase of something, when a particular, we can see there are some luxury items or expensive cars or expensive houses. When we make the purchase, then what happens? Our involvement will be more. The buying behavior will be complex. We take more time to reach at a decision, because once at a time, and all human beings, they are some of the very rarest positions, or you can say once in a lifetime positions. Like, first is house, second one is a car. And whenever they go for the purchase of that, they take lots of time. They go for the search of many of the information, whether everything is correct or not, price is good or not. Because when middle class people, they go for do that, they take lots of time. But when it is, again, income level and somebody from the affluent class, well-to-do family, they don't have any influence on this buying behavior because they have plenty of money. They take those decisions in fraction of seconds because they have lots of money. So here, if brands are difference are significant, as well as where involvement becomes high, because where you are going for a purchase of very high priced or expensive products, taking expensive services. Go to the next quadrant where it is low involvement but significant differences in the brands. That means when you go for purchase of those products where brands are significantly different from each other, but those customers, they involve themselves very low. The reason is they are want to just change their habits, to change the brands. Sometimes it happens with us also. ଆମେ ଏବେ ଗୋଟେ କିଛି ସାବୁନ ଲଗେଇଲା, ଏବେ ଏଥର ଗୋଟେ କିଛି ଡିଓ କିଣିଲା, ଡିଓଡ୍ରେଣ୍ଟ ଗୋଟେ ୟୁଜ୍ କଲା, ନେକ୍ସଟ ଟାଇମ୍ ଦେଖିଲା ବେଳକୁ ଆମେ ଆଉ ଗୋଟେ କିଛି ୟୁଜ୍ କଲା, ନେକ୍ସଟ ଟାଇମ୍ ଆମେ ଆଉ ଅଲଗା କିଛି ଟ୍ରାଏ କରିବା. ହ୍ୱାଇ ଇଟ୍ ହାପନ୍ସ? ବିକଜ୍ ଭେରି ଇଣ୍ଟେନ୍ସନାଲି ୟୁ ୱାଣ୍ଟ ଟୁ ଚେଞ୍ଜ ୟୋର୍ ୟୋର୍ ବ୍ରାଣ୍ଡ୍ସ. ସୋ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ଭେରାଇଟି ସିକିଂ ବ୍ରାଣ୍ଡ୍ ୱେର୍ ଦେର୍ ଆର୍ ବ୍ରାଣ୍ଡ୍ ଡିଫରେନ୍ସ ଆର୍ ଦେୟର୍. Whenever you go for the purchase of the deodorant, the fragrance is different from one to another, but still you take another one. You're not loyal to the same brand because you want the variety in your life. So that time your involvement will be low. Next one is dissonance reducing buying behavior, where involvement is high but differences are few. Why it happens? Because when differences are few in the brands, but still why there is higher involvement? Because people, they don't want to take more risk. Even if it is difference is not that much, but they minutely differentiate among in their mind, and they take high involvement to, because they anticipate some of the risk, purchase risk. And to reduce that, they involve themselves highly. And last one is habitual buying behavior, where your involvement is low as well as there is less difference in the, or less differentiation in the brands. Because when you go for you're buying any bread or dal, sugar, salt, whether it is Nirma salt or whether it is Tata salt, that time you will not involve too much because you are habitual, you're habituated to buying all those things. So in that case, both other things will be low. So in the next slide, we can see that the stages of buying decision process. I will go with the one by one, the stages. The first one is the, my question is, when we go to make a purchase, when we feel that there is a need. Suppose you want to buy a smartphone. When you go to buy a smartphone? Because either now it is damaged, now it is old, now it is hanging too much, now it is not supporting some of the apps, now it is all people, they are having good camera mobile. For that reason, you got tempted and you will recognize a need, whether there is a need of buying a smartphone or not. If not, there is no need of making a purchase. If need is there, then you will go for the information search. For example, you need a mobile with good megapixel camera. And what you do, you are not technological savvy people, savvy person. That time, what you will do, you will go for search. You will search in many ways, external search, internal search, your reference group. You'll ask your friend, what mobile I should get, or you ask to that person whom you feel that he's an expert in mobiles, and he will give you the right opinion about the different brands. That time you go for the information search. After that, you come to some of the alternatives, whether I should go for the MI, or I should go for the Samsung, or I should go for the even Asus or Lenovo or Infocus or even Apple. So in that case, you will go for the alternatives, evaluate, and you will evaluate all those alternatives by comparing their attributes. What is the price? Because all people, they want to extract more value out of less money. That is a truth. And many people, they buy that kind of things where they will pay less, but they extract more value. So here, when I'm giving the example of the smartphone, you will compare which one is the cheaper and which one is giving more specifications. So you will compare and you will reach at a decisions. Then you will go for the purchase decisions. You make the purchase, and after that, many of the people, they go for introspecting themselves. Had I bought the same, the good one, whether my purchase was good or I did a mistake. And in many cases, many of the people, they repent. Oh, that was a very horrible brand. Why I went for buying those brands? After the service was very poor and the response from the company was very poor, they repent. So it happens in the post-purchase behavior, and that is a learning process. And in many cases where you are more satisfied, you are highly satisfied, you repeat that purchase. And when you are dissatisfied, in your lifetime, you never go for purchasing such a brand. And that happens. So it is an introspection process. It happens when you make a purchase, and after some time, you ask yourself whether you did right or not. Next slide, please. The next section, that is market and market segmentation. Usually, when we talk about market, many people say that very short, we say that it is a place where sellers and buyers, they meet. But now total world becomes a global market. Now there is no place. There is number of markets are there. And in modern times, we can say that the market is a collection of buyers. It is according to the economist. Collection of buyers and sellers who transact a particular product category or the range of products or services. It is according to economist. But marketers say the sellers as constituting the industry and the buyers as constituting the market. And it really matters. But here we can see different markets, like physical market is there, virtual market is there, and international market is there, usable market is there, reseller market is there, number of markets are there. But broadly, we categorize into four categories: the consumer market or business market, or it is called the industrial market, where end user is not it is involved. It is totally business market. For example, Reliance Fresh is buying something from a particular company directly. Here, there is no involvement of the end user. So there is a business market, right? In some of the commodities, we can say that even they are consumer products as well as industrial products. They can, when they are sold in the industrial market, they are called as industrial goods. For example, if potato is sold in the consumer market, it's a consumer goods. When potato is sold in an industrial market for the potato chips, then it's a industrial market, it's a industrial goods. So market is different. And global market, because there are domestic market as well as global market. And nowadays, many of the companies, even I know that the largest conglomerate we have, Tata Group, they are having domestic market in a different way, and they are having their global market something matching to the global standards. At the same time, we have government market as well as non-profit market. Everything is happening today, the situation of pandemic, COVID-19. Government and non-profit organizations, they come to play a role, and this market is now very effective, very active. Next slide, please. Yes, market segmentation. Segmentation words, it says that it's a division, it's a segregation, or it's a filtration. Because it is not possible for all those companies to serve all the customers, because we have different sets of tastes and preferences. We cannot say whatever I like to eat, the same person, the different person, even in families, they have the different taste. So that happens. And all the people here, South Indian people, they like something else. North Indian people, they like to eat something else. Even in Northeast people, their food habits are different. So it depends. And market has to be segregated, it's had to be filtered, because you have to focus on a particular segment, particular division, so that you can focus on that. You cannot cater all those people alike. So you have to make the segment. Take the example of Hindustan Unilever. Their skincare product, where they have different soaps. Some people, they like Dove. Some people, they like Breeze. Some people, they like Little. And some people, they like Lux. And so many. Even Pamami is there. Okay. So why it is happening? And why they are offering so many types of soaps? They could have offered one kind of soap even prior to this globalization, 1991. HUL is there, and they were offering very limited number of brands. But why it expanded? Because the taste and preference from different companies, it really expanded. Number now choices are big, and they're minutely giving different type of people different products. Take the example of the Colgate. It's a product from the Colgate Palmolive, and it is a very popular product in the India. In past, Colgate was having one only Colgate regular or Colgate basic, but now you'll feel Colgate is having lots of variants, lots of different you can say different category people, they've segmented. Like Colgate Kids, Colgate Basic, Colgate Max Fresh, Colgate Herbal, Colgate Total, Colgate Neem, Colgate Active Salt. So why it is happening? Because they want to cater. And like some people, even recently they have Colgate Dead Shakti. Those people, they love to have natural ingredients. They will go for the Dead Shakti. And some people, they feel that Colgate Basic is a very nostalgic product. They stick to that. And some people, they want freshness. They go for the Colgate Max Fresh. And some people, they really want very white teeth. They go for the Colgate Whitening Special. So a company can really segment those things. A toothpaste can be segmented also. So it is, again, it is a division of the different products. There's a basis where market can be segmented, on which segmentation can be done in different ways or many ways. than the four also, but still broadly it is segmented in, or four bases are taken for the segmentation. For example, first one is the geographic, second one is the demographic, third one is the psychographic, and fourth one is the behavioral. Here, when we see that geographic, a few minutes before, I told that South Indian people, they have the different taste, different reason, different taste. Here, Thai people, they eat something else. Mexican people, they eat something else. Indian people, they have different. Punjabi people, they have the different. So reason wise, we are having different things. Climate wise, market will be different. Like in the hot regions, you'll find that selling of air conditioner, selling of refrigerators, it will be higher. But when you see that Simla, or you can see Daringbadi, you'll not find air conditioner that much. Fridge will be there, but air conditioner selling is not that much. Right? Climatic condition, market is formed like that. If it is a hot region, then there is a demand for different things. Market density, that particular, how much it is dense, how much it is populous, how much it is having huge number of potential customers. Again, geographic. Even in India, we are having market segmented into, you know, South Indian, Central, Northeastern. Even in global way, we can see that Gulf market or South Asian market or Latin American market. So why? The reason why is they have been segmented, and all those people, they have the different taste preferences. Market size. In some cases, you'll find the market size is very, very thin, very less. And in some cases, in some geographical regions, you'll find the demand from for the product of yours, it will be very high. So again, it matters. Second one is demographic segmentation. Demography means the study of the population, where we go for the different factors like age, occupation, gender, income, marital status, social status, family size, education, religion, all those demographic factors. Because age matters. According to age, many of the segments, gender wise, market is segmented. Like I give an example of that, where when only bikes were there, and when scooter arrived in the market as a product, it was considered to be a product for the ladies who can ride on that. But in that time, it was perceived as a very, very heavy for the ladies. And when Scooty was there from the TVS, it was a massive hit, because people, they or you can say the college going girls or working women, they feel that Scooty is a absolute right choice for them to commute. Later on, many of the companies they just dropped into this segment, this ladies scooter segment or ungeared scooter segment, Bajaj, or you can say this TVS, all people, they have dropped into. TVS was there, but Honda, which was known, or Hero Honda, which is known for the bikes only, even they came up with a ungeared scooter called Pleasure, and with a different tagline. Why boys should have all the fun? Because it was targeted to the, or they are having the different segment, ladies segment. They are focusing on the that ladies segment. So that is the demography. With the demography, we can see the gender or income. Why income is taken? When you go in a train, you'll find that there is a different classes, like general class is there, or you can say this sleeper is there, third AC, second AC, first AC. Why it happens? And even in flights, you'll find that the economic class or the business class. So it is according to income, the capability of paying capability, those markets are segmented. I'll switch on to next one, which is psychographic segmentation. That means it is totally with the psyche, exactly the lifestyle, how the personality is. Some people, they are jovial personality. Some people, they're very reserved personality. So it depends what type of personality they're having, what type of value they're having. Like, we perceive that we Indians, we value many of the things than the Western country people. It is our perception. Okay, so in that segmentation also, what Indian people they value to the particular brand, according to that, that segmentation really operates, right? And fourth one is the behavioral segmentation. Okay. It is about the occasion. Like, we have different occasions are there. For example, there is a marriage market, we can say, in winter time, or you can say in summer time, you'll find that gudai sabu bahagara mane hochi au se time re praya sabu mandap mane beshi booking raibo. এটা ডিপেন্ড করে তোমার ওকেজন উপরে কিছু লোকর ইয়ে থাকে কি বেনিফিট কু নিয়ে গোটে সেগমেন্টেসন বনাতে হলো মু যদি গোটে এক্সাম্পল দেবি কি আমি গোটে ইয়ে রু অলগা অলগা বেনিফিট আমি কেমন পাইপার সেইটা বি আমি দেখবা যেমি কি আমি যদি ওয়াশিং মেশিন আমি কপড়া ধোছু কিন্তু যদি পঞ্জাব সে ওয়াশিং মেশিন যদি লসি বনাও বিকজ উই আর এক্সট্রাক্টিং ডিফরেন্ট বেনিফিটস অ্যান্ড those people, they are extracting different benefits. They are making lassi on that. So it is about the segmentation. It is about segmentation, what kind of benefit they are extracting from the particular brand, a particular product. Next slide, please. It's a case study. So I have given to understand better this market segmentation. It is about the milk, or it is called as the ultra high temperature milk, or it is called as the UHT milk, because at the high temperature it is pasteurized, and the milk is made like it has larger shelf life. It can really can be validated to a longer period of time, because you know that milk is not a particular commodity, it's a perishable commodity. It can last only 2 to 3 days, and it has to be supplied through the cold chain, otherwise your total milk will be destroyed. So what happens in northeast or many of the remote areas where the milk supply is not adequate, and they have to be dependent on the condensed milk or dairy whiteners. So they are not the exact replacement for the milk, cow milk. So in that case, this is the initiative from the Parag Milk and DS Group to launch this ultra high temperature milk, which can have a very longer shelf life. So again, when that milk was launched, it was more than the 60 rupees per liter, but it was sold, and it was that company was self dependent, because they are having their own farm, and they really monitor their quality at high level. So it was good, and they used to sell around 3,000 liters, but later on they have segmented their market, and they have launched 3 types of milk, like toned, double toned, and slim fit. So 3 types of milk for different segments, even with the different prices. You can see that the prices are 58, 57, and 60. Okay, so by giving this milk, they can really supplement the milk deficit in the northeast and those remote areas where there is no availability of the cow milk. So that is a case study where it is why the segmentation is so important and how effectively segmentation can be applied to focus in total market. Okay, next slide, please. It is just like a process where first one is the segmentation, then targeting, then positioning, and briefly it is called as STP. Okay, so it starts with the segmentation where you will decide on which segment you want to cater, you want to serve, and then you will come to that one. When segment is ready, then you will target the particular market, which is the audience. That means market targeting is the evaluating the different segments and deciding how many and which one to target for. Like in earlier times, when today also when we heard about Johnson & Johnson, the total perception comes to our mind that it's a baby product, okay, baby powder, baby oil, baby shampoo. But later on, you know, it's a perception, it's a baby product. Okay. But in 1970s, Johnson & Johnson wanted to just change the segment and how to target different people. Okay, so this will again, I will give you this example when it is again another example for the positioning also, where the Johnson & Johnson, they have changed their positioning. When it was perceived that Johnson & Johnson only producing those baby products, with a advertisement, they come up with a lady. And the tagline was this particular baby moisturizer can make your skin baby soft. That means now they are targeting both the segments, women and baby or infant. So that means they are targeting a particular segment or particular audience who can be our customer, because you cannot target all those people. And targeting can be different ways. Next slide, please. So targeting strategy can be in four ways. One is undifferentiated or mass marketing. Another is a differentiated or segmented marketing. Third one is a concentrated or the niche marketing. Or fourth one is micro marketing. That means, for example, कपड़ा धुआ साबुन हो कि बर्तन माजिवा साबुन हो कि हमें बहुत पार्ले जी बिस्कुट हो कि किसी गोटे जिनस हो जोटा कि बहुत इनएक्सपेन्सिव एंड एवरी वन कैन बाय सो दैट टाइम वी गो फॉर द अनडिफरेंशिएटेड से ही पार्ले जी को से धनी लोक भी सेटा खाइब आउ से गरीब लोक भी सेटा खाइब किसी प्रॉब्लम नहीं समस्त सामान किसी प्रीमियम क्लास ना किसी लोअर क्वालिटी ना So you are targeting everyone. This is called the mass targeting, or it is called the undifferentiated marketing. Okay, and second one is differentiated, where you are categorizing many other people because in you can have some of the products for lower middle class people, some of the products for those people into middle class or upper middle class, and premium products for rich people. It can be done because you'll find many of the, for example, you take the example of the Samsung. In Samsung, you'll find different models for the different class. Tanka pakare. दस हजार भी फोन अच्छी पाखे लक्षे उपरे दाम भी फोन अच्छी वेर आपल रही सेगमेंट टा अलग आम आपल विषय तल नेक्स्ट किए को गला बेले आपल कथा कह आईफोन विषय कह बट यही केस रे आम देखिए जब मारुति जदि आम मारुति सुजुकी कथा कह दे हैव अ वेरी डिफरेंशिएटेड बिकज से कौन कर अल्टो को लोअर लोअर इनकम और यू कैन से दैट लोअर इनकम तो आम कही पारे बट ଆମେ ମିଡିଲ କ୍ଲାସ ପାଇଁ କହିପାରିବା, ଯେଉଁମାନଙ୍କୁ କି ମାନେ ବେଶୀ ଏଫୋର୍ଡେବିଲିଟି ନାହିଁ, କାର୍ ନେବାଟା ତାଙ୍କ ପାଇଁ ଗୋଟେ ସ୍ୱପ୍ନ ଥିଲା, ସେମାନଙ୍କ ପାଇଁ ଏଭେଲେବଲ୍ କରିବା ପାଇଁ ଅଲ୍ଟୋ, ତାପରେ ଧୀରେ ଧୀରେ ଅଲଗା ଅଲଗା ରେଞ୍ଜର ତାଙ୍କ ପାଖରେ ଅଛି, ଇଭେନ୍ ସମଥିଂ 14, 15, 16 ଲାକ୍ସର ଇଏ ପର୍ଯ୍ୟନ୍ତ କାହିଁକି ଅଛି, ବିକଜ୍ ଦେ ୱାଣ୍ଟ ଟୁ କ୍ୟାଟର ଅଲ୍ ଦୋ ସେଗମେଣ୍ଟ, ସବୁ କ୍ଲାସ ପାଇଁ କିଛି 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 ଅଛି, ସମସ୍ତଙ୍କ ପାଇଁ ଆମେ କିଛି କରିପାରିବା। ଆମେ ଯେତେବେଳେ କହୁଛୁ କି କନସେନଟ୍ରେଟେଡ୍ ଅର୍ ନିଶ୍ ମାର୍କେଟିଂ, ଦ୍ୟାଟ ମିନ୍ସ ୟୁ ଆର୍ ଫୋକସିଂ ଏ ସ୍ମଲ ଗ୍ରୁପ ୱେର୍ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଭେରି ରିସ୍କି, ନୋ ଡାଉଟ୍। ହ୍ୱାଟ ଏଭର୍ ଦ ଆଇଫୋନ୍ ଅର୍ ଆପଲ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଡୁଇଂ, ଦ୍ୟାଟ ଇଜ୍ ଟୋଟାଲି ନିଶ୍ ମାର୍କେଟିଂ, ବିକଜ୍ ନଟ୍ ଏଭ୍ରି ୱାନ୍ ଇଜ୍ କ୍ୟାପେବଲ୍ ଅଫ୍ ମେକିଂ ଦ ପର୍ଚେସ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଆଇଫୋନ୍ସ, ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ କଷ୍ଟଲି, ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏକ୍ସପେନ୍ସିଭ, ସୋ ଦେ ଆର୍ ଟାର୍ଗେଟିଂ ସମ୍ ପିପଲ, ବଟ୍ ଷ୍ଟିଲ୍ ଇନ୍ ନୋ କେସ୍ ଆପଲ୍ ଇଜ୍ ରିଡ୍ୟୁସିଂ ଇଟ୍ସ ପ୍ରାଇସ୍, ଦେ ଆର୍ ସିକିଂ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦେ ଆର୍ ଫୋକସିଂ ଟୁ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲର ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର ସେଗମେଣ୍ଟ, ହାୟର ସେଗମେଣ୍ଟ। ନାଓ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଅଲ୍ସୋ ସମ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦି କାର୍ସ ଦେ ଆର୍ ଫର୍ ଦ ରିଚ୍ ପିପଲ୍, ୟୁ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ସେ ମେ ବ୍ୟାକ୍ ଅର୍ ୟୁ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ସେ ଦିସ୍ ରୋଲ୍ସ ରଏସ୍, ଦେ ଆର୍ ନଟ୍ ଫର୍ ଦ ଅର୍ ଲାମ୍ବୋର୍ଗିନି, ଦେ ଆର୍ ନଟ୍ ଫର୍ ଦ କମନ୍ କମନ୍ ପିପଲ୍, ଦେ ଆର୍ ଫର୍ ଦ ରିଚ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ their sell or their marketing is very limited, but they are focused on a particular small segment which is much more profitable. The important thing is that when you cater to this kind of niche market, when you are successful, other people they afraid of giving entry to that segment because it is very risky and it is of the high price. And in case of the smartphones, you'll find one is OnePlus and another is iPhone. They basically serve the niche category. And fourth one is a micro marketing. In that, you can have the two different categories. One is local marketing, another is the individual marketing. Local marketing means you are customizing your product according to the local needs. That means you are changing your product. For example, you are making something for India total, but your versions are different for Bengal, for different for Odisha, for different for even Andhra Pradesh. That means you want to keep all those people, you want to make all those people happy, and you are concentrating that you can be connected locally. So that is the issue, that is the main objective. But in case of individual marketing, where you are focusing on the individual customers and where you can customize your product according to the one to one, so that is again, it is, that's why it is called the micro marketing. So here the targeting from the broad to it goes to narrow one, from undifferentiated then differentiated then concentrated then the micro marketing. So targeting can be that go in that way. Next slide, please. This is positioning. Positioning refers to the place that brand occupies in the minds of the customers and how it is distinguished from the products of the competitors. Positioning, that means ame kichi jinsa dekhile ama mind ko mind bhitare kichi posi jae, kichi bosi jae. ଆଉ ସେଇଟା କେବେ ଯାଏ ଫର ଏକ୍ସାମ୍ପଲ ୱି ସି ସମଥିଂ ଅନହେଲ୍ଦି ଦେନ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ ଟାଇମ୍ ୟୁ ନୋ ୱି ପରସିଭ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର ପ୍ଲେସ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର ରେଷ୍ଟୁରାଣ୍ଟ ଦ୍ୟାଟ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର ହୋମ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର ଥିଙ୍ଗ ଭେରି ଅନହେଲ୍ଦି ଦ୍ୟାଟ ମିନ୍ସ ଦ୍ୟାଟ ଇଜ ଦ୍ୟାଟ ରିଏଲି ଇଟ୍ସ ଏ ରିଏଲି ଅକୁପାଏସ୍ ଅଫ୍ ମାଇଣ୍ଡ ଆମେ କିଛି ଆମର ଟିଚରମାନଙ୍କୁ ଦେଖୁଛୁ କେଉଁ ଟିଚର କହିଲେ ଆମେ ଭାବୁଛୁ କି ସେ ଟିଚର ବହୁତ ବହୁତ ରାଗି ଥିବେ ସେଇଟା ଗୋଟେ ପୋଜିସନିଂ ସେ ଯଦି ବହୁତ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରିକ୍ଟ ଅଛନ୍ତି ଆମ ମାଇଣ୍ଡରେ ପଶି ହେଇଛି କି ସି ବହୁତ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରିକ୍ଟ ହେଲା ସମ୍ ପିପୁଲ ଦେ ଆର୍ ଭେରି ଭେରି ଜଭିଆଲ ସେ ଟିଚର ନାଇଁ ସେ ଟିଚର ବହୁତ ଜଲି ଅଛନ୍ତି ଆମେ କ'ଣ କରୁଛୁ କି ଆମ ମାଇଣ୍ଡରେ ସେସବୁ ଜିନିଷ ପଶିଯାଏ ଯେମିତି ଆମେ ଆଜିକା ଡେଟ୍ରେ ଯଦି ଆମେ ଟେକ୍ନୋଲୋଜିକାଲି ବହୁତ ସାଉଣ୍ଡ ଆମେ ଇଏ କରିବା ଯଦି ସାଉଣ୍ଡ ସିଷ୍ଟମରେ କମ୍ପାନୀ କଲ୍ଡ ବୋସ୍ ୟୁଏସ୍ରୁ ଇଏ ଅଛି ବୋସ୍ କମ୍ପାନୀ ଏକୋଷ୍ଟିକ୍ସ ଇଏରେ ତାଙ୍କ ଇଞ୍ଜିନିୟରିଂ ବହୁତ ହି ସାଉଣ୍ଡ ଆଉ ଆମର ସେଇ ଇଏ ଅଛି କି ତାଙ୍କର ଯେଉଁ ପୋଜିସନିଂ ରଖିଛନ୍ତି ମାନେ ସାଉଣ୍ଡ କ୍ୱାଲିଟି ଏକ୍ସଲେଣ୍ଟ ମାନେ ସାଉଣ୍ଡ ଇଞ୍ଜିନିୟରିଂ ଦେ ହାଭ୍ ଡନ୍ ଏକ୍ସଲେଣ୍ଟ ଜବ୍ ସୋ ଆମର ପୋଜିସନିଂ ଯୋଉଟା ହଉଛି ମାଇଣ୍ଡରେ ଆମେ କିଛି ପୁଟ୍ କରିଦଉଛୁ, ଯେମିତିକି ରତନ ଟାଟା ସେ ତାଙ୍କର ଯୋଉ ଡ୍ରିମ୍ କାର୍, ତାଙ୍କର ଯୋଉ ମ୍ୟାଜିକ୍ କାର୍ ଯୋଉଟା ଲଞ୍ଚ କରିଥିଲେ ନ୍ୟାନୋ, ନ୍ୟାନୋ ବେଳକୁ ସିଏ ଗୋଟେ ଜିନିଷ ପରେ କହିଲେ ଦାଟ ପୋଜିସନିଂ ଅଫ୍ ନ୍ୟାନୋ ୱାଜ୍ ନଟ୍ ଗ୍ରେଟ୍, ବିକଜ୍ ଇଟ୍ ୱାଜ୍ ପୋଜିସନ୍ ଆଜ୍ ଅ ଭେରି ଚିପେଷ୍ଟ କାର୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ୱାର୍ଲ୍ଡ। ଦାଟ ମିନ୍ସ ଇନ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିଆନ୍ ପାର୍ଲାନ୍ସ ୱାଟ୍ ୱି ପରସିଭ୍ ଦାଟ ଇଫ୍ ସମଥିଙ୍ଗ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଚିପେଷ୍ଟ ଅର୍ ଚିପର ଦେନ୍ ମାଇଟ୍ ଆଜ୍ ଅ ଭେରି ସବଷ୍ଟାଣ୍ଡାର୍ଡ କ୍ୱାଲିଟି, ସୋ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ନଟ୍ କ୍ୟାପେବଲ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଅର୍ ଇଟ୍ ଶୁଡ୍ ନଟ୍ ବି ପର୍ଚେସ୍ଡ। ସୋ ୱେନ୍ ଇଟ୍ ୱାଜ୍ ପୋଜିସନ୍ ଆଜ୍ ଏ ସବସେ ଶସ୍ତା ଗାଡ଼ି, ଦେନ୍ ଇଟ୍ ୱାଜ୍ ପରସିଭ୍ ଭେରି ରଙ୍ଗଲି, ସୋ ଇଟ୍ ୱାଜ୍ ରଙ୍ଗଲି ପୋଜିସନ୍। ଓକେ, ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ ଇଜ୍ ଦ ଥିଙ୍ଗ, ଦ ପୋଜିସନିଂ ମିନ୍ସ ପୁଟିଂ ସମଥିଙ୍ଗ ଇନ୍ ଟୁ ଦ ମାଇଣ୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ ଦ କଷ୍ଟମର୍ସ। ସୋ ଦିସ୍ ଆର୍ ଦ ପସିବଲ୍ ଡାଇମେନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ହାଉ ୟୁ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ପୋଜିସନ୍, ଲାଇକ୍ ଲୋ ପ୍ରାଇସ୍ ହାଇ ପ୍ରାଇସ୍, ବେସିକ୍ କ୍ୱାଲିଟି ହାଇ କ୍ୱାଲିଟି, ଲୋ ଭଲ୍ୟୁମ୍ ହାଇ ଭଲ୍ୟୁମ୍, ନେସେସିଟି ଲକ୍ଜରି ଲାଇଟ୍ ହେଭି ସିମ୍ପଲ୍ କମ୍ପ୍ଲେକ୍ସ ଅନହେଲ୍ଦି ହେଲ୍ଦି, ଲୋ ଟେକ୍ ଅର୍ ହାଇ ଟେକ୍, ଇନ୍ ଡିଫରେଣ୍ଟ ୱେଜ୍ ୟୁ କମ୍ପେୟାର ଦୋଜ୍ ପ୍ରଡକ୍ଟ ଆଣ୍ଡ ୟୁ କିପ୍ ଇନ୍ ୟୋର୍ ମାଇଣ୍ଡ ଦାଟ ଏଇଟା ଭଲ ଥିଲା, ଆଚ୍ଛା ସେଇଟାର ବ୍ୟାଟେରୀ ଭଲ ନଥିବ, ସେଇଟାର କ୍ୟାମେରା ଭଲ ନଥିଲା, ତ ତମ ମାଇଣ୍ଡକୁ ଯୋଉଟା ପଶିଯାଏ ଜିନିଷଟା, ପ୍ରାୟ ଲୋକ କହନ୍ତି କି ନାଇଁ ଓପୋର ଓପୋ ମୋବାଇଲର କ୍ୟାମେରାଟା ବହୁତ ବଢ଼ିଆ ଅଛି, ଦେନ୍ ୟୁ ପରସିଭ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦୋଜ୍ ପିପୁଲ ତାଙ୍କ ମାଇଣ୍ଡରେ ବସେଇଦେବେ ଯେ ନାଇଁ ଓପୋ ଛଡ଼ା ଆଉ କୌଣସି ମୋବାଇଲର ତାର କ୍ୟାମେରା ଏତେ କ୍ୱାଲିଟି ନଥିବ। ତ ଏକ୍ଜାକ୍ଟଲି ସେଇ ପୋଜିସନିଂ ହେଉଛି ସେଇ ଜିନିଷ, ଆମେ ମାଇଣ୍ଡରେ କିଛି ଜିନିଷ ବସେଇଦେବା କି ସବସେ ଶସ୍ତା କି ସବସେ ମେହଙ୍ଗା କି ସବସେ ପ୍ରିମିୟମ କ୍ୱାଲିଟି, କିଛି ଲୋକ କ୍ୱାଲିଟିକୁ ନେଇକି ପରସେପ୍ସନ୍ ବସାନ୍ତି, କିଛି ଲୋକ ପ୍ରାଇସ୍କୁ ନେଇକି ବସାନ୍ତି, ଆଉ କିଛି ଲୋକ ଟେକ୍ନୋଲୋଜିକୁ ନେଇକି ବସାନ୍ତି। ଇଭିନ୍ ଆଜିକା ଡେଟ୍ରେ ଆମର ମାଇଣ୍ଡରେ କେବେ ଯେଉଁମାନେ ଆଗରେ ଦେଖିଥିବେ ସୋନି ୱାଜ୍ ଲିଡର ଇନ୍ ଦ ଇନୋଭେସନ୍ ରିସର୍ଚ୍ଚ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ ଟୁଆର୍ଡ ଦ ୱାର୍ଲ୍ଡ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦେ ଆର୍ ନୋନ୍ ଫର୍ ଦ ଡିଫରେଣ୍ଟ ଡିଫରେଣ୍ଟ ରିଏଲି ବ୍ରେକ୍ ଥ୍ରୁ ଇନୋଭେସନ୍ସ। ଫର୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ରିଜନ୍ ସୋନି ଇଜ୍ ଟୁଡେ ଅଲ୍ସୋ ଦେୟାର କଲ୍ ଏଜ୍ ଏ ଟେକ୍ନୋଲୋଜିକାଲ ଲିଡର ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦେ ଆର୍ ପୋଜିସନ୍ ଆୱର୍ ଇନ୍ ମାଇଣ୍ଡ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଏଭର୍ ଦ ସୋନି ପ୍ରଡକ୍ଟ ଦେ ଶୁଡ୍ ବି ଟେକ୍ନୋଲୋଜିକାଲି ଭେରି ସାଉଣ୍ଡ, ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦ ପୋଜିସନିଂ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ସୋନି ହ୍ୟାଡ୍ ପୁଟ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଭେରି ଭେରି ପର୍ମାନେଣ୍ଟ। ଓକେ, ନେକ୍ସ୍ଟ, so that's all for today. Whatever the questions with this session you can ask me, I will try to answer all those questions.
Hello. Hello, dear learners. If you have any questions to ask, you can type it in the message box. Hello, Srima sir.
Hello, sir.
Yes, sir. I think, sir, sir, the learners have not asked anything in the chat box. So,
आउथरे पछरे दोन यदि के कहबे बोले भल कथा नले विल वाइंड अप द सेशन।
Sir, sir, sir. Any learners want to ask any questions to our resource person? Yes, please. Yes, please. Yes, Srimad sir, there is one question, I think. Sir, how market density and market size affect under geographical segmentation?
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Density means how much it is closely situated. How much it is closely situated, like when we call it as a population density, in one square kilometer, you'll find in somewhere it is too dense, like 50 to 60,000 people they are staying, and somewhere it is there, they stay very scattered, something around 15 to 20 people in a 1,000 or you know, one square kilometer. So that is the density. So market density is how much it is too close. But market size means the volume, the market volume. It doesn't depend on the, you know, density. It depends on the how much it is bigger in the size. Like in many of the Indian companies, they are having markets in the Latin America, South Africa, Eastern Africa, Australia. So it is not dense, but it is very large because they are having larger markets in volume. So that is the difference between the market density and the market size.
Thank you, sir. Any more questions? Any more
Can
questions
I add
from
one
anybody?
More point here, sir?
Sure, sir, please.
Market size. So when we are talking about market size, we can certainly discuss two things. The size of the market can be defined as, first, number of customers. Second, what is the total value of the market in terms of revenue? And what is the total value of sales or in terms of volume? So number of customers, volume, and so these three Hello. Points can be you know, useful in defining the market size or determining the size of the market: revenue, number of customers, then profit, and sales volume.
Yes sir. Any more questions? Sir, should we wind up?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you all the learners from Odisha State Open University. So this session has come to an end, and it is very nicely explained by Srimad sir about the behavioral aspects of the consumer, and also how to fix our target markets. So as all of you know, that consumers are the most unpredictable creature in the world. Okay, so consumer have specific wants, needs. Their income varies from high to middle or low. They are given choices of thousands of products, from luxuries item to basics to necessary. Okay, so they have many different traditions and tastes, ranging from ethnic to generic products. So they are actually very unpredictable. So it is very nice experience
Kirat sir, got a question asked.
Yes, sir. There is a question from Ankita Mishra, and she is asking about retention of consumer. How to retain a consumer?
Retention means when a customer or when a consumer comes to you for the first time, have you catered his or her needs properly or not? If you have catered their needs and wants properly, they will be overjoyed, they will be oversatisfied, and they will come back. And many times, so when you go to eat something in a particular restaurant, when you find the taste is something unique and you are satisfied, and you find that taste is good, at the same time the price is very, very reasonable, very nominal. For that reason, you thought, you know, in the less price, I'm getting more. That time you're more satisfied and you will return back. You will make the repeat purchase from that restaurant. You will visit that restaurant repeatedly. So that is the retention. And with the proper understanding of the customers, company, time to time, they come up with different offers and number of things to retain back their customers. so that company will survive for the longer period of time. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. So retention of customer means what? It is a key to market. It is a key to marketing nowadays, because once a customer is gone, then it is very difficult to get him back, actually. So it was a very nice experience, sir, and we learned about the behavioral aspect of consumers, what is market, what is market segmentation, types of market, brand positioning. So you actually explained it with very good examples also, and so thank you, Srima sir, thank you, Dr. Anshuman sir, and so this is the end of the session. And thank you all. And I would like to request all the learners to get themselves disconnected from the session. Thank you.
Thank you, Kiro sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.